Well, here we go then, people. We're back on that radio teleswitch once again. It's in Toby's room on the wall. If I tilt that camera down a bit, have yourself a look at this. There we are then, it's all wired up. Yes, I've wired it up, and what I'm going to do in this little experiment, this is going to be an overnight experiment as well. We're going to see if that thing switches on. Okay, it's about 7:30 in the evening now, or 1930, depending on which way you choose to say it. I'm expecting that radio teleswitch to operate around about somewhere between, I would say, 11 o'clock and 12 o'clock tonight. Okay. Yeah, so somewhere between 11 and 12 o'clock tonight. How I know that it will operate is, if I tilt the camera down towards the floor, there it is then. What we got down there on the floor is a Sangamo S250, and that doesn't have a backup battery in it, okay, mainly because it's supplied without one. So what will happen is, when that radio teleswitch turns on, if it turns on, that thing down there on the floor will start ticking, okay, and then of course when it turns off again, it will stop ticking. So not only will it provide an evidential record of when it turned on, but it was also, after turning off and stopped ticking, then provide an evidential record of how many hours it was switched on for. Okay. That time switch down there on the floor, I have set it for the time that I expect the radio teleswitch to turn on, which would be 2300 hours. And let's say, for example, I've set that to turn on at 2300 hours, and I came into the room at, shall we say, 2330. And if that also says 2330 on it, then I know that it turns on bang on 11 o'clock at night, or 2300 hours. Okay, so on and so forth. Whereas if there's like an offset, for example, like say, I'll come into the room at 12 o'clock at night, okay, or midnight, and that's only advanced on 30 to 23:30, then I shall know once again that it turns on at 23:30 at night, okay. It's just a little bit of careful deduction, mathematics, as to determine the operation time, the on operation time of that radio teleswitch. Okay, currently I've got the teleswitch energized. As you probably noticed at the beginning of the video, if I tilt that camera back up at the radio teleswitch, that lower cover looks like it's half hanging off. That's because it is. If I tilt that camera down a bit, lower the camera down a bit, if I take the front cover off, there's something in there that I would like to show you. Right, watch this. I don't know if you'll see it. Oh yes, you can see it in there. Look at it glowing. Just in that corner then, just there, that little LED that we looked at in the What's Inside video, which almost escaped my attention. There it is, it's glowing. And also, with that, this little manual switch here, if I was to press that down, I can say that the time switch does start ticking, the one that's on the floor that we was looking at just now. Okay, and if I pull that back up, it the time switch stops ticking. So I only like made it tick for about 5 or 6 seconds, and then I stopped it. Okay, so there we are. It's plugged in and then energized in. Again, I don't know if that's a power indicator, whether it should be glowing. It could be, when it lights up, it could say that there's an error. I don't know. I don't know what that little light does. Maybe even when the off-peak load turns on, Depending on how much power's being pulled, that thing will start flashing on and off. Who knows? Because I most certainly don't. That's what this video's about. We're going to do a multi-section video on this. So, a little bit later on tonight, around about the expected time, I'm going to do another section and stitch it onto this. But for now, I'm going to put that cover back on, because I don't want that cover hanging off like that, because, well, there's always that risk of electric shock. I don't really think you can put your fingers in there and get a wallop, but let's not take chances. So I'm going to put that cover back on. There's that little glowy light in there. The cover goes on. I don't think you can see that glowy light from the outside when the cover's on. So there we go. I'm just going to hand tighten those screws, actually. I don't need to nip them up with a screwdriver. There we are then. Okay, so that's energised, and it's just a case of now waiting to see whether or not that thing picks up the switching signal and turns on. Where are we on this section then? 6 minutes. We're going to tie it up for 6.5 minutes then. Just wait. Well, when I say wait, it'll be straight after this, because I'm going to stitch another section on, and it'll either be later on tonight or during daylight hours the next day. And of course, depending on which one it is, we'll determine whether or not that thing's working. Now, if it's not working, okay, it's either stuffed, or what I might have to do is undo that top cover after disconnecting it from the supply, of course. And if you remember, in the What's Inside video, we've got that antenna in the top there, and it's got a setting for A and B. What I might have to do is take that top cover open, whip out that little antenna and flip it onto the B setting, the antenna B setting, and then put that cover back on and try the experiment again. Okay, so it's just a case of waiting now and seeing if we get any action out of that radio teleswitch. Like I say, I've got the time switch down there on the floor, which is going to be our evidence logger. Okay, and of course, at a later time tonight, if I hear that thing ticking, I'm going to read off how far that's advanced on from 2300 hours, and from that I shall then be able to determine at what time that teleswitch turned on. Yay! The radio teleswitch has activated. The time switch is running, people. If I look at my watch, it's 23:16. Okay. So there we are. The radio teleswitch has activated. And if we look in there, I'm holding the camera so it might be a bit wobbly. You can see that the little red thing has dropped. So that is now turned on. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to put you on the floor here next to the time switch. We'll take that cover off and see how much it has advanced on. And from that, I should be able to tell when it activated. Okay then, right, that is currently at 23:45. Okay, it's 23 there. Okay, then we've got 23:15, 23:13, 23:45. It's currently 23:17 on the watch. So if I take 45 minutes off of actual time, then that would be 10:30. That somehow says to me that the radio teleswitch activated at 10:30. So now what we do is, we leave it to run overnight now. Well, in the morning, when I get up, I shall have a look at this time switch once again. And we shall see how far that has advanced on from the 2300 hours. Now, if this is this radio teleswitch, if it is economy 7, then I will expect the that time switch. See, it's got the 6 o'clock there. I would expect that number six, to be down there next to that pointer. Okay. So there we are. The radio teleswitch, it works and it has activated, people. Okay, it's received its switching signal. It has activated. And now the time switch is running. The next section of this video will be sometime tomorrow. Well, it'll be tomorrow for me, but from where you're sitting, it'll be stitched onto the end of this. So, yeah, just hold on there. Hello, people. Just a very quick update on what's happening with the radio teleswitch just before I go off the bed. As you can see, it's 16 minutes past 2 in the morning, and I thought I'd just get a little update in before I go to bed as to what's happening with the radio teleswitch. I've kept it powered up, okay, but I've had an interesting little development, okay. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you over to the laptop screen now, and we're going to discuss a little bit more in detail about that time switch that's on the output, which is going to be logging the amount of hours that the radio teleswitch is turned on for. Okay, let's go over to the laptop screen now. Okay then, in that video, you've just watched that section actually. What we got there then, there's that time switch, and what I've done is I've wired it to the output, and if you remember, I set that on to 2300, okay? In that video, we got 3/4 of an hour out of it. Okay, as you can see, it's currently at 23:45. Okay, but I've just been in the room. If I just pause that video about there, here you go, I've paused that video. Now you can see the pointer at the bottom of the video screen there, and that is the time indicator. Okay, and as you can see, that's at 23:45. Okay, now I went into the room just to check on the radio teleswitch, okay, a matter of minutes ago. And you see that number one on the clock face there, that is now at the pointer, and the radio teleswitch has turned off. Okay, so if that time switch was originally on 2300 at the pointer, and that number one is now at the pointer, that means only 2 hours. Okay, now this brings me on to a couple of things. Okay, it's either the radio teleswitch, it could be faulty, or seeing that the darn thing is remotely operated, if you get a set amount of off-peak hours per day, you don't actually get them in one block like what you would do with a time switch, okay? Because when you think about it, because the radio teleswitch is remotely operated, you know, there could be a high possibility that you'll get off-peak hours, as and when it takes a fancy, you know. How can I put it? Well, let's just say it to this way. Let's say, for example, in a particular region in the UK, there's like an excess of electricity and they need to get rid of it somehow. They just send out a region code and switch on a load of these radio teleswitches and bingo, you know, and they can control the amount of electricity that's being consumed on the national grid at any particular time. You know, if, like, say, for example, somewhere a big load suddenly switches off. Let's say, for example, I don't know, 65 kilowatts suddenly disappears. All of a sudden, they've got this 65 kilowatts. They haven't got, you know, they haven't got anywhere to put it. So they just send out a couple of region codes. A load of radio teleswitches turn on, and yeah, you know, they've suddenly got another 65 kilowatts of load to play with. And then what they can do is slowly switch them all off as they wind the generator back down. You know, I don't know, but I've kept the radio teleswitch energized upstairs. I shall be doing another update at around about midday tomorrow, and well, we shall see if that time switch has advanced on any more than one. Okay, because upstairs in Toby's room at the minute, that number one is at that pointer. Okay, we started off at 23, and now that number one is facing downwards at that pointer, which basically means it's only registered 2 hours. Okay, so yeah, it's not quite like the economy 7 that you get on a time switch. Okay, so really speaking, the radio teleswitch, it wouldn't be any use basically where if you wanted to put your washing machine on and your tumble dryer overnight on off-peak electric, because if you've got the washing machine and the tumble dryer going and the radio teleswitch decides to switch off, all of a sudden that big old load that you've got going on, it gets recorded onto peak rate electric. Okay, and that's probably why the person got rid of the radio teleswitch, because they were fed up with keep being ripped off. Okay, so yeah, you know, it's one of them things. But like I say, I've yet to give this thing a full-on 24-hour cycle, and let's see in that 24 hours how many off-peak hours we register on that time switch. Okay, so just for the record, I set that time switch up at 2300. Okay, it's advanced on 2 hours to one, and it's currently upstairs in Toby's room with the output turned off. Okay, so we'll have to see if we get any further advances within 24 hours on that time switch. I'm off now. Okay, the next update will be about midday tomorrow, and we'll see if we get any more on that time switch. And there we are. The only thing I won't be able to tell is when it reactivates and when it turns back off again. Okay, so almost 7.5 minutes on this section then, while I was explaining to you what's happening with that radio teleswitch up in Toby's room. Okay, it's currently turned off, so I'm off now. Next update will be stitched on to the end of this. Okay then, here we are, next day. And I've got a bit of a 2-in-1 update for you people. As I was shooting the section downstairs in the kitchen last night, I didn't notice, but straight after shooting that section, I had to bring the camera tripod back up to Toby's room, and when I come in the room, the time switch on the floor was ticking away, which basically means at around about the same time as I was shooting that video section downstairs in the kitchen, that radio teleswitch up in front of the camera there decided to switch back on. So yeah, a bit of a, like I say, 2-in-1 update, this one. I thought I was only going to get 2 hours out of that thing. But no, it turns out that it did actually switch back on. Okay. Let's go to the little time switch on the floor then. Just down there. You can see it just there. And let's see how many hours it logged. I started that, if you remember, I started that on 2300 hours. Okay, I said that, well, my predictions are that I would get 7 hours. Okay, so if it started off at 2300, by the time we get 7 hours locked on that time switch, it should say, you know, it should stop ticking when the number 6 is at the time pointer on that time switch. Let's take the camera off the tripod. Let's get down there and have a look at more closer up. Look at that little time switch and see how many hours it did actually log. Surprise, surprise. There it is. It stopped at the number 6. Okay, you can see it there. So I've started it off at 2300 hours and it stopped at 6. And that obviously means that the radio teleswitch run for a total of 7 hours. But, as we found out, you don't get the whole 7 hours in one block. Okay. From what I can remember, I think I managed to catch the radio teleswitch turning on at 10:30. And if it done 2 hours, then it switched off again at 12:30. And then back on again at 2:30 in the morning, or thereabouts. Now that's something. If it turned back on at 2:30 in the morning, I'll then have to work out what time it turned off after sunrise. Okay, so the one's up there, because that's where it switched back on. So that must have been 2:30. 2:30, 4:30, 5:30, 6:30. There you go then. 7:30 in the morning, that radio teleswitch turned off. Okay. So there you go. So just to recap then. Started at 2300, and it turned on at 10:30. Okay, and then 12:30, it stopped there at the 1, and then 12:30, and then 2 hours later it switched back on, and then took us all the way down to the 6 down the bottom there, and that takes us up to 7:30 in the morning when the radio teleswitch turned off. So that concludes that then. But we've still not done a full 24-hour cycle in real time, okay? Although it's another day now, we're still not up to 10:30 tonight. What I'm going to do is I'm going to leave that radio teleswitch energised on the wall socket, and let's see between now and 10:30 tonight, or just before that, if that time switch advances on any further, okay? If it does, I should add another little section onto the end of this. And even if it doesn't, I'm going to add another section onto the end of it anyway as a little concluding, closing part to this little sequence of videos, which I'm going to stitch together, of course. Well, you know that because you've just watched them all. So, I'm going to put the cover back on the time switch then and just leave that over there as it has been for the past few hours. And we shall see if, as and when it happens, if and when it happens, if that radio teleswitch turns back on. Right. There it is then. Just sat over there. And there's a radio teleswitch then. Okay then, people, don't adjust your screen, your television set, or your YouTube, or whatever. Yes, it's completely dark in the room, because it is that time once again. We're back on that radio teleswitch, okay? It's 25 minutes past 10. I took a guess last night, about 24 hours ago, that it turned on at around about 10:30, okay? Because I managed to catch it 3/4 of an hour later on the time switch. And we're about to go over to that now. I've got a little little LED torch here. If I turn it on, there it is. Okay, radio tele switch. Okay, and it's not connected up to the light in the bedroom. I just turned it off for added effect. Yeah, there it is. I don't know if the camera actually, because it's really difficult to see it. But, no, you can't see that. I was just wondering if you'd be able to see that little glowy light in there. I would have to take the little cover off the front so you could see it in there glowing. Yeah, since the last section, there's been no advance on that time switch down there. Okay, it's still on the 6. So, I've got a feeling the next interval on that timer, on that radio teleswitch, will be around about 10:30. I'll get my watch. It's 10:26 now. So yeah, see, this has been in, you know, I'll just turn that light on in the bedroom. Watch your eyes. Okay then. Well, I can save my batteries on my little torch now. So it's well, as I figured it out, you get 7 hours of off-peak on that. You don't get the 7 hours in one block. Okay, if it's going to go the same tonight, you know, it's not down to me as to when it turns on. It's when they transmit the switching signal. But if it goes to plan tonight, then what's going to happen is, in a couple of minutes, if I'm not standing in the way of the signal, that thing's going to switch on, and the time switch is going to start up. Yeah, that's what I'm really looking for. I'm going to switch on in a couple of minutes, and then the time switch will start ticking. We'll get 2 hours. Okay, so that'll take us up to, what'll it be, 12:30. And then it'll switch off again. Okay, and then round about 2:30, 2 hours later, it'll then switch on. And you get another 5 hours of off-peak. Okay, quite why it's not done in one block is unknown to me. But then, having said that, it might be something to do with the region code it's set on. Okay, there might be other settings where you do get one lot of 7 hour block. And there's probably others where it's staggered through the night. You might get a couple of off-peak hours during the day, and so on and so forth. Okay, I'd seem to think there's different kind of tariffs and goodness knows what else. But then, well, what with the arrival of electricity meters that have got their own built-in timer, and possibly antenna as well, these things up in front of the camera there are starting to become rather redundant now. Okay, that's probably why that one there is up in front of the camera. It's no longer needed, it was removed. My watch now says on it 10:29. And spot on the dot, it has operated. Okay, so there we go. I've managed to figure that one out, people. Let's go over to the time switch then. Right, as you can see by the little time indicator down the bottom, let me just get that angle right. You can see that that time switch is spot on the number 6 there. So if we're going to get another 7 hours on that, that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So by about 7:30 tomorrow then, that number 12, which is up there, is going to be down there by that time indicator. Okay. So I'm going to come back just short of 2 hours then. Okay, so that'll be 12:30 tonight. I'll just set my watch because it's got an alarm on it. Put it on my wrist, and that will then be the next section. 12:30 tonight. I'll stitch it onto this, and away we go from there. Hold on there just a moment. Okay then. 28 minutes past 12 at night, and we're just waiting for that radio teleswitch to turn off. Okay, I've focused in on the little red thing just there. Let's see as and when it turns off. Okay, so now it's just a waiting game. And as if by magic, it's just turned off. So there we go then, we've got the 2 hours. And if I'm right in saying, it will be 2 hours from now, that will turn back on again. Okay, so there we are. I hope you got the sound of the time switch on camera ticking away, and the sound of that doing its little clunk. Okay, that's why I wasn't saying anything when it operated, because I wanted to get the sound of that on the camera. And there we are. Okay, so I should do another section around about 2:30 a.m. Okay, 2:30 in the morning. And then that'll be it then. So we've got 2 hours so far. And then if all goes to plan, around about 2:30, which is 2 hours from where I'm standing, it will jump straight onto the next section for you. But around about 2:30, that thing should operate again, and the time switch will then start ticking, and that is when I'll have another 5 hours added onto it. Okay, so hold on there just a moment for that. Wait for it, peoples. Well, it does not appear to be operating. It's either 2 o'clock it operates, or 2:15, somewhere around about there. What I'm going to have to do is just stop this video, go back a couple of clips, and look at the video properties of the one which I recorded downstairs in the kitchen a couple of sections back. Okay, hold on there a moment. Okay then people, I checked the section of video where I shot in the kitchen, and I started that video recording at 2:15 in the morning. It went on for 7 minutes, so by the time I got back up to Toby's room, the time must have been about 2:30 in the morning. Now I did do another section at 2:15, but nothing happened, so that section got scrapped. So we're going for 2:30 in the morning, and it's now just a case of waiting. Hopefully, there it is. Okay, so it has activated at 2:30 in the morning. Okay, my watch is 30 seconds slow, so it does operate at 2:30 in the morning, and so therefore we're probably now going to be looking at a switching off time of around about 7:30 in the morning. Okay, because it's got to have another 5 hours added on to that time switch. So I'm off now for the night. What I should do, I shall set my alarm for around about 7 in the morning. I shall get up and I shall film that time switch, the radio teleswitch turning off. Okay, so this section of video ends with a close-up on that time switch. Here we go then, just for the record, it's coming up for 7:30 in the morning. The radio teleswitch is still active, but only just. I'm going to get the camera on the tripod very quickly, and over we go to the radio teleswitch. Just there then. And there it is. It's just operated. I only just got that camera on the tripod quickly enough. So that concludes these little batch of videos then on the operation of this radio teleswitch. The time switch has stopped ticking due to the fact that the output of the radio teleswitch has now been turned off. Okay, it's received switching signal as per the predicted 7:30 in the morning and turned the power off. Okay, so now that it has, let's go back to the time switch and see how many hours it logged. Well, there it is then. Okay, if you have been watching this right from the beginning, you will know that that time switch was originally set for 2300 hours, and it now says 1300. So the total amount of off-peak hours have been logged as 14 hours. Okay. And so therefore, it done two operations, so that is two lots of 7 hours, but it didn't do two lots of seven-hour blocks. Okay, it turns on at 10:30 at night, and you get 2 hours. It turns off, and then it turns back on again at 2:30 in the morning, and back off again at 7:30 a.m. as indicated just a couple of minutes ago. So there it is then. Okay, like I say, this is the concluding section now. That plug just behind the time switch, I shall be unplugging that after I've turned the camera off, and then that's the end of it. What I would like to do though, in another video, on another day, is to rig up that radio teleswitch to an electric meter. We'll get it to do a rate change and maybe even switch a nice big hefty load. Okay, because that would be nice to see that thing clunk in a nice big hefty load and get a load wheel to whack around at a very satisfying speed. Yeah, that brings that to an end. I'm going to put the cover back on the time switch and stop dust getting in there. There it is then. So, I'm going to disconnect everything after this video, and that brings that to an end. So, for me, the radio teleswitch and the Tobias, it's over and out for now. Tobias.